Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve the issue hash include errors detected, please update your input path. So this error can come in both C and C++ and the solution is common for both the languages. So let's get started. So the first thing what you need to do is, you need to just click over here, just place your cursor over here and click it, and you'll be having this bulb like icon. So just click it and you'll be having this edit input path setting. And before clicking this option, you need to open your C or C++ program in a folder. So I have just opened the file. So if I just now click it, I'll be having this open a folder list to edit configurations. So for that, I will just go here and create a new folder. Let me name it as CPP Pro, something like that. And I will just put my file inside it. And again, I will go to my Visual Studio Code and go to open folder. And I will just now select it. So again, just place your cursor over here and we'll be having this icon. Click it and just click edit input path setting. So this time we will be taken to C/C++ configurations. We won't be getting that pop-up now. And in this, you'll be having this IntelliSense configurations. And here, after this underlying word, you'll be having this ccppproperties.json file. So just hover over it and just click it. And you'll be getting this .json file opened. And here we need to make two changes. The first change is we need to change this include path. So for that, what we need to do is you need to go to the location where we have installed MinGW. So I am having MinGW installed in C MinGW. In some cases, it will be present in C program files MinGW. So you need to check the path where you have installed this MinGW. So I will just go into mine and you need to go to include. And you need to just copy this path. It's C MinGW include. And let me just now go and I will just paste it over here within double quotes, and all the single slash should be changed to double slash. So otherwise it will throw an error. Yeah, that is fine. And now let me just save it. And after this, we can just change the compiler path. So for that, we can just go to C or C++ configurations. And if I just now scroll down, so here you can see I'm having this compiler path over here. So what I can do is I can just press this down arrow icon and I will be going with g++.exe because I am going to do this for C++ programming. If you are doing for C programming, you need to select GCC. So since I am doing C++, I will select G++. So I'll just click it. Yeah. So, and it will automatically getting changed over here as well. So I'm having another issue over here, which is this IntelliSense. So for that, let's just scroll down. So here you can see it is not compatible. So for this, you can just go with the default. It solves the issue, or else you can go with this Clang one. Yeah, this one. So both the things solves the issue. I will just go with the default one. Yeah. So now you can see I'm not having that yellow color line. So it is now fine, I guess. So save it. Important thing, after doing all the changes, Control S over here. So now if I just go to my C program again. Yeah, so this time you can see I am not getting any errors. And if I just now go to my problems, there won't be any problems. And if I now go to my terminal and I will do G++. What is my program name? It is newpro.cpp. So I need to get the output as hello. So I'll just type EA and hit enter. So here you can see it is running successfully. And another thing that I wanted to tell you was you will be getting this .vscode folder within your C++ project folder. So I would recommend you to always use this particular folder for creating or running your C++ programs. So that said, this is how you solve the error. And mine is a programming channel. I have done many videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.